Welcome to this video in which we will focus on a digital filter. We will explain the convolution sum, which is a procedure in which the filter processes the input signal samples. Although most real-world signals are continuous time, or analog signals, most processing of these signals is nowadays performed in the discrete time domain by a digital filter. For example, a continuous time audio signal XT sounds as follows.
Try to remove the sine wave in this wave file.
The speech contains an annoying disturbance. By converting this continuous time signal XT to the discrete time domain, it becomes relatively easy to remove the disturbance. Converting the resulting signal back to the continuous time domain, it sounds as follows.
Try to remove the sine wave in this wave file.
In this video, we will focus on the digital filter, from which the input and output signals samples are denoted by respectively xn and yn, both square brackets. Let's first look to the following very simple own created example, in which the finite length sequence of signal samples xn consists of a slowly increasing trend, mathematically described by 1.01 to the power of n, and a disturbance, mathematically described by this sinusoidal term. In order to find the trend, we need to remove the disturbance from measurements of the signal samples xn. This can be achieved by a so-called m-point averaging filter. Each output sample yn of this filter is equal to the average of m consecutive input samples xn. The result of applying an average over ms3 or ms7 is depicted in the plots. From these plots, we observe the following when increasing the length m. By averaging over more input samples, the output samples yn contain less fluctuations and the trend becomes more clear, but also the length of the output sequence becomes longer. The input-output behavior of a digital filter can be described by its difference equation, abbreviated as DE. In the previous averaging example, all input samples are weighted by the same number, 1 divided by m. In general, we can use different weights for each sample xn. These weights are denoted by the scalar numbers bk. In this general case, the difference equation describes each new output sample, yn, at time index n, as a weighted linear combination of m delayed input samples xn, in which m is the order of the digital filter. In practice, we can only make so-called causal filters. This implies that each new output sample yn can only be created by using weighted current and previous samples xn minus k, and no future samples. In order to implement such a digital filter, we need the following basic building blocks. A multiplier, to multiply a signal xn by a scalar. An adder, to add two different signal samples. And a unit delay, to delay a signal sample by one sample. Now let's find out a procedure in which the filter processes the input signal samples xn. For this, we use the example from which the implementation scheme is depicted in the figure. Each new output sample yn is equal to the input signal sample xn, weighted by a scalar b0, plus the delayed signal sample xn, which is denoted by xn minus 1, weighted by the scalar b1. Plus the delayed signal sample of xn minus 1, which is denoted by xn minus 2, weighted by the scalar b2. These operations are described by the given difference equation. Now let's assume that the weights of our example equal minus 1, 1, and 1 for b0, b1, and b2 respectively. Furthermore, let's assume that our input signal xn consists of only three samples, namely x0 is 1, x1 is minus 1, and x2 is 2. All the other signal sample values are equal to 0. Now if we look to the implementation scheme, we can calculate for each time index n the output signal sample yn by applying the calculations of the implementation scheme. So when we calculate the output signal sample yn at time index n is minus 1, we need the input signal samples xn with time indices minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Since all three samples are 0, the output yn at time index n is minus 1 is equal to 0. Next step is to calculate the output signal yn at time index n is 0. Now we need the input signal samples xn with time indices n is 0, minus 1 and minus 2. From the implementation scheme, it follows that the output yn at time index n is 0 is equal to minus 1. By following this procedure, we can calculate the output signal samples yn for n is 1, which results in 2, for n is 2, which results in minus 2, for n is 3, which results in 1, for n is 4, which results in 2, and finally for n is 5, which results in 0. It follows from this procedure that the result for all signal samples yn with time index n larger than 5 will result in 0. Concluding, it follows that for a given set of weights bk, in our case 3 weights, we use for every step the input signal samples in reverse order. By keeping this in mind, we can describe this procedure in a mathematical way as follows. Here we use the same example, but now we describe the difference equation by the given summation, from which the running index k ranges from 0 up to 2. In this summation we have two different indices, time index n, colored blue, and summation index k, colored red. As a first step, we plot the input signal samples x not as a function of index n, but as a function of index k. In the summation of the difference equation, the index k for signal x is negative. So we need to mirror or reverse the signal samples of x into x minus k. After that, for each new time index n, we have to shift these mirrored input signal samples to that particular position with index n. For example, if we start with n is minus 1, we shift the mirrored input signal to position minus 1, which results in the plot of x minus 1 minus k. The summation index k of the difference equation runs, in this example, from 0 up to 2. This implies that we only have to calculate the product of the weights with the reversed and delayed input signal samples, which are inside an interval, which is denoted by the green colored area. After that, the resulting products have to be added. For this example, this results into the value 0. Thus the output sample yn with index n is minus 1 is equal to 0. In a similar way, we can calculate the other output samples. For n is 0, we first shift the mirrored input signal to the position n is 0. Then we multiply, inside the green area, the weights with these shifted and delayed input samples. And finally, the addition of these products results into the value minus 1. Thus the output sample yn with index n is 0 is equal to minus 1. For n is 1, this procedure results into the value 2 for y with index n is equal to 1. For n is 2, into the value minus 2. For n is 3, into the value 1. For n is 4, into the value 2. And finally, for n is 5, into the value 0. This procedure is called the convolution sum procedure. So in general, if we have a filter of order m, the procedure of this convolution sum goes as follows. First, plot the weights bk of the digital filter as a function of index k. Then plot the input signal samples also as a function of the same index k. Mirror the input signal samples into x minus k. Shift for any new index n the mirrored input signal samples to this new position n. And for each new time index n, yn equals to the sum of the element by element multiplication of all weights bk and the mirrored and shifted input signal samples xn minus k in the range k is 0 until m minus 1. This convolution sum procedure is the basic filter operation for a filter as depicted in the figure. In a follow-up video, we will show that this convolution sum procedure is valid for a much larger class of filters. Now let's look to the following convolution sum example, in which the input signal is an infinite long sequence of samples, from which all even samples are 0 and all odd values are equal to 1. The digital filter is described by the given difference equation. And the question is to calculate the output signal for even and odd values of n. The answer can be found as follows. From the difference equation, we can derive the given signal flow graph or implementation scheme. From the convolution sum procedure, it follows that we first have to mirror or reverse the input sequence of samples. Because of the fact that the input signal is an even function, the mirroring operation results into the same sequence of samples. Furthermore, it follows from the implementation scheme that in order to calculate the output signal for any new index n, we only need 3 consecutive signal samples of the input. For all even values of n, this sequence is depicted as in the figure, which results into an output signal value of minus 1. On the other hand, for all odd values of n, this results in the value 2. Sometimes it's not straightforward to derive the difference equation from the signal flow graph or implementation scheme. In such a case, it's useful to indicate new signal symbols at strategic positions. For this example, we introduce 2 new signals, V1n and V2n, as depicted in the figure. Now we can write down the following difference equations for yn and V1n and V2n. In the next step, we substitute V2 into the expression of V1. And finally, we substitute V1 into the expression of Yn. The result is a difference equation which expresses the output samples as a function of the input samples. This ends this video, in which we explained the concept of a convolution sum, which is a procedure in which the filter processes the input signal samples. Thank you for your attention.